Hi everyone, this is Allie with Triple C, and today we are going to talk about lead forms. The lead form is otherwise known as an event inquiry form, which will allow your guests to submit details pertaining to their event. Once submitted, the inquiry will automatically populate within your Triple C dashboard. Either yourself or your web developer will add the form to your website, as well as anywhere else you would like customers to be able to submit an inquiry for an event, such as Facebook, Instagram, other various websites, or social media platforms. Your customer will fill out the lead form, entering in both their personal contact information as well as their desired event details. Once submitted, they will receive a confirmation message on the screen as well as an automatic email confirmation, and you will now see the lead within Triple C to manage. For more information on how to manage these received leads, check out our leads video. Here you are looking at an embedded lead form from our restaurant's website. This is set so that when a customer clicks on the private dining tab from the main screen of our website, they are brought right to this inquiry form. Using the embed lead form option will allow your web team to control the aesthetics of the form. This option is easiest for the customers to find on your website as it is embedded right into your page. Another option, instead of having the form living right on your site, would be to utilize the hosted lead form and have a hyperlink that says something like, "Click here to inquire about an event." After clicking on that link, the customer is then brought to an external page, which will ask for the same information. It will pull the branding of your Triple C site, which can be adjusted within the location settings. You can also make specific adjustments on the lead form edits page, which we will see shortly. To adjust current forms or add new forms, you'll need the appropriate access. Once you have access to this, you can head to settings and then select lead forms. Existing lead forms will be shown here, and you can click edit to adjust or the plus sign button to add a new event lead form. Keep in mind that you can have as many forms as you need. Additional forms can be added for different parts of your website, for example, a catering lead form or a private events lead form. This may also be done for forms that need their own branding, such as a holiday lead form. Groups with multiple locations can create joint lead forms if a parent company website exists. This will allow your customers to select which location they are interested in from a drop-down menu on the form. By adding in forms for different lead sources, you can track where your leads are coming from. Let's go ahead and start the process of adding a brand new lead form for our Facebook page. As I mentioned previously, the lead form will automatically pull in the branding based off your location settings, but you do have the option to override this branding. You may want to override the branding if you were creating a holiday lead form, for example, with a holiday-themed banner that you would like to show. It's important to note that you only have the ability to make basic edits to the lead form. We cannot add drop-downs or additional fields, as this would need to be worked out with your web developer through our open API. Moving on to the form field section, you are able to make some of these fields required, such as company, email, phone number, address, event date, guest count, and event description. Next, we have the lead source dropdown. Whenever this form is filled out, the lead submitted will track as a Facebook lead for our reporting. To add additional lead source options, you can head to Settings, select Preferences, and then click into dropdowns. Here you can set the different event styles available on your lead form, and your customer will see a drop-down of options to select from. They will be asked to submit different information based on the particular style, such as a catering address. Please note that the event styles that are checked off within the lead form settings here should also be checked off in the location detail settings in order for the guest to be able to submit a catering lead. Within the auto response email section, you can fully customize the message that gets sent to your client once they submit a lead. The subject line, as well as the body of the message, can be adjusted. To direct client replies on the autoresponse email, enter a team member's email address here. If you have the Fishbowl integration set up, which is now known as Personica, You can link this form with Personica here. As a reminder, lead notifications are set within location settings, and once you have completed the form, be sure to click Save. Once created, we can grab the codes that our web developer needs to add to our website by clicking on View All Setup Codes. If your team has a specific request for the type of code needed, such as a code that runs on iframe or through an API endpoint, you can also click Setup Codes on the right next to the form. You can click the View Live Page button to view the hosted version of the form. The URL of this page does not change and can be placed anywhere on the internet where you can place a URL or a link. Facebook posts, your Instagram or Twitter bio, or email campaigns could have this link built right in. Be sure you are on the correct lead form when copying codes or URLs. For example, if I'm adding a link to my Facebook call to action button or to a Facebook post, I want to be sure I'm grabbing the URL from the form created with Facebook as the lead source. This ensures my reporting will be correct when the leads come through. If I were to accidentally add the Instagram lead URL to a Facebook post, when submitted, it would come through as an Instagram lead. Being able to report on the lead sources and forms will help you identify which marketing strategies are working and which could use some reworking. Thanks for watching, and if you have any questions, please contact our support team using the Help and Questions button located at the top right-hand side of every page within CCC.